Hey everybody, my name is Goo. This is my kitchen, and this is Goo Eats. Alright, so today I'm going to eat South End chicken and waffles. Chicken and waffles is something that's pretty popular in the southern United States. Hasn't really taken off here in Canada, but my goal in life is to change that. Chicken and waffles is amazing, and I'm going to show you how I do it. Alright, so South End chicken and waffles. Now, it's really not that difficult to make, but it does take a little bit of prep work. The prep work that actually begins the night before. What you do is you just take your chicken pieces, breasts, thighs, wings, legs, whatever you choose to use, get it primed, just rinse it off first, pat it dry, and then season it a little bit with some salt, pepper, garlic salt, onion powder, paprika, a little bit of cayenne, and just a little pinch of poultry seasoning. And then what you do is once it's all covered in all of that seasoning, just put it in a container. You can even use a Ziploc bag or something like that with some buttermilk. That's right, just fill it with buttermilk, throw it in the fridge, and leave it in there for at least 6 hours. Personally, I prefer overnight though. All right, now we're gonna make the dredge. So first off, we have some flour in there. I've already put salt and pepper. Now we're just gonna add in some more paprika, some garlic salt, about a quarter of a tablespoon of ground cumin, and a secret ingredient, just a pinch of cinnamon. Get it all mixed right in there. So the chicken is out of the buttermilk bath, and we're going to take it over, put it into the dredge here. Now you want to really get a lot of it on there. Really just dredge it right in the flour mix. Take a little bit of the extra off. And there you go. And then just go ahead and repeat for the rest of your chicken. All right, so the fried chicken in, you want a nice thick pan like this. And you're gonna put a bit of oil in there. About a quarter of an inch is what I have in the pan. Now, you can use any kind of oil you want. Personally, I prefer to use peanut oil for this. And then we're just gonna go ahead and turn the pan on to about medium heat. All right, so it's been a little while here. Let's check the pan, see how hot the oil is. A little splash of water. Popping, we're good to go. Ready for the chicken. One of them, two of them, get them right in there. And then run for cover. They start to sizzle up nicely. All right, now you're just gonna leave them like that for about 7 minutes and then flip them for another 7 minutes. All right, so we're ready to flip these bad boys over. Look at that, nice and golden brown on that side. I want to achieve about the same thing on the other side. All right, so now that the chicken is pretty much ready to go, the next step is the waffles. Now, I don't have a waffle iron, so I'm gonna have to go ahead and use frozen toaster waffles for this South End chicken and waffles. Every day I'm waffling. Let's get those babies down. Look how golden brown this chicken is. Now, 7 minutes on each side, about 15 minutes total cooking time, should be enough. But because it is chicken, just do yourself a favor, double check, make sure that the internal temperature is at least 170 before you go ahead and take it out. Let's move it on over here to some paper towel or a drying rack, whatever you happen to have. Just want to make sure you get some of the grease off and wait a good 10 minutes before you break into it, because it is going to be mighty, mighty hot. All right, well, there you have it. Some South End chicken and waffles. Mmm. Doesn't that look good? A little south in your mouth. You definitely want to make sure you get some table syrup on the waffles. Even if it gets mixed in with the chicken, some nice sweet with all the savory. It's really, really delicious. Let's take a look at the chicken piece there. It's a nice crispy skin on it. Look at that, nice and juicy still. Oh, this is gonna be delicious. Pretty good. Now you're gonna think I'm crazy, but even with this table syrup, a little bit of your favorite hot sauce on top of the chicken, oddly enough, it marries together really, really nicely. Definitely recommend giving that a try. A little chicken and waffle on every bite. In the meantime, I'm gonna enjoy this, but never trust a skinny cook, and fat guys do it better.
My grandma and your grandma were sitting by the fire. My grandma told your grandma, I'm gonna set your flag on fire. You're talking about hey now, Aiko, one day. Giacomo Fino, Annale, Giacomo Finale. Look at my king all dressed in red, Aiko, one day. I bet you $5 he'll kill you dead, Giacomo Finale.